Pratt and Valerie have the night off. The U of A says there will be no Pac-12 or NCAA tournaments for the team this season, and this comes 2 months after the university received a notice of allegations from the NCAA. Not on Your Side's Jason Barr is live outside of the McHale Center with the latest. Jason.
Yeah, Shondrea, how's this for a way to cap off 2020? The U of A self-imposes a one-year postseason tournament ban. It is for what they say are lapses in judgment and unethical behavior by certain former members of the basketball staff, not current ones. Well, we know who they are. Certainly former assistant coach Book Richardson, who pleaded guilty to federal bribery charges involving recruits. He recently spent 3 months in prison, as well as former assistant coach Mark Phelps, who allegedly tampered with the transcript of a recruit and bought a plane ticket for another player. You can't do that. Arizona was recently hit with 9 NCAA violations in October, 5 of which were the most serious. Those are called level 1 allegations. The Athletic reported that Sean Miller was charged with a lack of head coach control. The case will be heard by an independent accountability process, and it's likely to wrap up in the spring. All right, today, some statements. First, from Dave Hickey, the athletic director at U of A. The decision to self-impose a postseason ban was extremely difficult, as we recognize the impact it has on our current student athletes. We will continue to cooperate fully with the NCAA enforcement process and continue to support the hardworking young men in our men's basketball program. Basketball coach Sean Miller. I understand and fully support the university's decision to self-impose a one-year ban on our men's basketball program. Our team will remain united and aggressively compete to win a Pac-12 championship. Now, to be clear, Miller is referring to the Pac-12 regular season championship. They're not going to compete in the Pac-12 tournament in Las Vegas and obviously the NCAA tournament. Now, this is not the first time that Arizona has self-imposed a penalty. It happened back in 2010, and I'll talk more about what happened in that situation when I join you later at 6 o'clock. For now, live outside McHale Center, I'm Jason Barr, KGUN 9.